something's under the bed, and now it's out on the hedge. There's a big black crow sitting on my window ledge, and I hear something scratching through the wall. What should I do? I'm just a little baby. If the lights go out, maybe, then the wind just starts to moan outside the door. It followed me home now, goodnight moon. I want the sun if it's not here soon. I might be done and it won't be too soon till I'm saying. She wanted to be a concert pianist. That was what she wanted to be, and that was what she wanted her career to be. So she went to Juilliard School of Music in New York in 1951, where she trained for a year to, she had been obviously learning piano before that, but she went to Juilliard to train for an audition for a college in Philadelphia where she was going to do her master's in music. But when she did the audition, and she absolutely aced it, but they refused her entry on the colour of her skin. So she was heartbroken, obviously. She went back to New York and, well, decided to go and play in piano bars. So she realised then that she'd make more money by singing as well. But I think, when I listened to her sing, well, before I say that, I should say she got involved in the civil rights movement then after that, and she was a strong, strong advocate getting rid of all those laws. The Jim Crow laws and all those laws. But when she sings, I can really almost hear her disregard for the vocal end of what she's doing, because she really just wants to be playing the piano. But it's that almost disregard and the throwaway nature of the way she sings that just makes her so incredibly unique. And you can really hear her heartbreak when she sings. So lots of people covered this next song, but I'm thinking of Nina Simone when I sing it. She really sings it with a lot of heart. So this is Lilac Wine.
I lost myself on a cool, damp night. I gave myself in that misty light. Was hypnotized by a strange delight. Under a lilac tree, me see.